This video was brought to you by GeneralPac.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPac. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Fault Analysis in Power Systems, Part 4A. Reflecting fault currents and voltage values on the high voltage side of the transformer. This is the first video in Part 4 in the series of Fault Analysis in Power System. In this video, we will see how the faults are analyzed from the high voltage side as opposed to the low voltage side of the transformer, which we have done in previous videos. This is step number 7 in our fault analysis methodology, which was discussed in part 2A and serves as an additional bonus concept. Up until now, we have been seeing calculations and methodologies on faults on the low voltage side of the 13.8 kV transformer in our example. But let's suppose that the fault is still on the 13.8 kV side of the bus, but we need to know what the same fault current and voltage values are. However, this time seen through the high voltage side of the transformer or the 115 kV side of the bus. This is useful for many instances in power system protection and analysis. Because of this usefulness, we will reflect the fault current and voltage quantities of the low voltage side towards the high voltage side. Now, to do this, we have to account for two changes in sequence current values. The first involves the magnitude due to the change in voltage level, and the second involves the angle, since we have the delta Y transformer and the angle will be subject to change. Now remember that per unit values of sequence voltage and current quantities will remain the same. This is one of the benefits of the per unit system, which we viewed in the introduction to per unit series by GeneralPac. See the description section below for a link. Now, to account for the change in magnitude as a result of analyzing the fault on the high voltage side of the transformer, we simply change the base value of the voltage from 13.8 kV to 115 kV. Now, this allows us to convert the sequence per unit values of currents calculated earlier to the sequence ampere values reflected on the 115 kV side. The table below summarizes the changes in magnitude concepts. On the high voltage sides, the base current was equal to the base value of power divided by the square root of 3 times 115 kV, and that essentially equal the base value of current on the high voltage side. On the low voltage side, however, we simply take the base value of power and divide that by the square root of 3 times the 13.8 kV voltage magnitude, and that equals the base value of current for the low voltage side. For the high voltage side and the low voltage side, we essentially calculate the ampere values by multiplying the per unit current, either low voltage or high voltage values. And by utilizing the right formulas, we can simply calculate the ampere, either high voltage current or the low voltage current. Now, the positive sequence values are defined in the summary table. However, a similar procedure can be performed for the negative sequence component or the negative sequence value. Since the transformer is a delta Y transformer, there will be no zero sequence current on the high voltage side because the delta winding traps the zero sequence current within itself. This is quite evident with the zero sequence network diagram as shown below, and we will certainly see zero sequence current flow on the low voltage side. However, on the high voltage side, zero sequence current is essentially zero for all fault types involving ground. Now, this was discussed in great detail in part 2C of this series, and you can check out the description section below for a link to that video. Now, up until now, we have been talking about magnitude adjustments for positive, negative, and zero sequence current, which we know is non-existent on the high voltage side. Now, we will shift our gear and consider consider the second factor, which is the angle adjustment. Because we have a very specific delta Y transformer connection where the low voltage line current lags the high voltage line current by 30 degrees, or another way of saying this is that we have a DY1 or a standard DAB delta Y transformer connection, because of the delta Y transformer connection and the difference in angles between the line current on the high voltage side and the line current on the low voltage side, we need to consider this transformation when we are reflecting the low voltage positive sequence and the low voltage negative sequence currents, both of them on the high voltage side. Now, please watch our highly in-depth tutorial on the introduction to delta Y transformers to get a better understanding by what we mean when we say DY1 or a DAB transformer connection. Now, in this figure below, we clearly see that the low voltage positive sequence line current lags the high voltage positive sequence line current by 30 degrees. This makes sense because we know that the positive sequence current follows the same rotation as a system phasors. So when we are reflecting the low voltage sequence line currents on the high voltage side, we need to advance by 30 degrees, which can be accomplished by multiplying the low voltage per unit line current value by one angle 30 degrees. Again, this is to calculate the high voltage positive sequence line current value in per unit. Now, keep in mind that if we had a different type of a delta Y transformer connection, then we would have to adjust the phase angle relationship accordingly. For the negative sequence current in the figure below, we clearly see that the low voltage negative sequence line current leads the high voltage negative sequence line current by 30 degrees. Now, this makes sense because we know that the negative sequence current effectively follows in the reverse rotation as a system phasors. So when we are reflecting the low voltage positive sequence line current on the high voltage side, we need to delay by 30 degrees, which can be accomplished by multiplying the low voltage negative sequence current in per unit values by one angle negative 30 degrees. Again, this is to calculate the high voltage negative sequence line current value in per unit. Now that we understand how to adjust values of sequence component currents, provided that we have very specific delta Y transformer connection, in our case a DY1 or a DAB, we can now move forward with reflecting the fault current on the high voltage side for any given fault on the low voltage side of the transformer. And then from there, we can easily calculate the voltage quantities as well, although they are a bit more complicated. Now, in the next video, we will show how to put this into effect in the calculation examples for a specific type of fault on the low voltage side.
Now, we hope that you find this video tutorial valuable and useful as a professional or student, and we hope that you support us by becoming our patron and subscribing through patreon.com/GeneralPac. Your generous subscription will help us continue to make high quality power system video tutorials. Thank you.